हाय, गुड इवनिंग।
ऑडिबल एंड द वीडियो आर फाइन, कैन ऑल ऑफ यू सी क्लियरली? ओके, स्टेरिलाइजेशन नीड्स टू बी डन, राइट? इट हैज़न्ट बीन कवर्ड अर्लियर, नो? Okay, let's start with sterilization. What do you understand by the term sterilization and how is it different from disinfection? The definitions have also been MCQ, so you need to be quite clear with the definitions. The important MCQ here. Okay? What do you understand by sterilization when you're actually killing the bacteria or removing the bacteria from any surface, whether it is in a resting state or whether it is in a vegetative state? So you're basically bringing about complete elimination of the bacteria. In case of disinfection, what happens is you're only removing it and from the surface, and you're not actually dealing with the spore form, that is the dormant form of the bacteria. So there is a chance that when you clean a surface, and also another thing is disinfection is what we do for any of your floors, walls, your tables and etc., things like that. That's where you're doing a disinfection. Whereas autoclaving or procedures that we need to do at a medical dental setup is sterilization, where you not only deal with the killing of the existing bacteria, but also deal with eliminating the bacteria which are in a dormant state, that is the spore form. Is there a voice problem with everyone? Okay. Is it better? Is the voice better now? Okay. All of you are clear with the difference between sterilization and disinfection. In disinfection, you are not removing the spore forms. In sterilization, you will be removing both the vegetative as well as the spore forms. It's simple. Sterilization will completely eliminate the organisms, whether they are in a vegetative state or in a spore state. Vegetative state matlab an actual bacteria which has the capability to divide, while disinfection is not going to remove the spore forms. It is only going to kill the existing bacteria without actually dealing with spore forms. And definition is an important MCQ. It is going to be asked many times in your papers, so be very clear with that. Are all of you clear with it? Okay, and the simple difference between a disinfectant and an antiseptic is both are against your microorganisms, effective against your microorganisms as bactericidal agents, okay? But if I have to say in layman terms, antiseptic is what is used on living object, while a disinfectant is something that you used on a non-living object. In fact, the whole process of disinfection itself is mainly for your in layman terms, from the non-living objects, like I was specifying earlier, floors, right? Got it? Yeah. Let's look at the different age. reagents or methods through which you can do sterilization. First, we will go to hot air oven. We will be first dealing with heat as a technique for bringing about sterilization. In that, you have hot air oven. Jisme, you need to know from an MCQ point of view as what is the duration of time and what is the temperature. Very important MCQ. So this is an important MCQ, which is it is done for 160 degrees and the process is going to be done for 1 hour. Another MCQ that you're going to get frequently is what are the materials that will be sterilized in through the hot air oven. See, it's simple. It has a high temperature. Okay, so you're going to actually not use very weak objects which are, you know, susceptible to heat and is going to break or something like that. But you do use glassware, use your forceps, scissors, scalpels, swabs, especially liquid paraffin. This has already been asked. Then dusting powder, which has also been asked. These are the methods you will use in hot air oven. Okay, these things will be used, these will be sterilized by the process of hot air oven. Now, when you do any sterilization procedure, you need to be sure that whatever process you're doing is accurate, isn't it? Now suppose it says 1 hour, at the end of 1 hour you need to check if the bacteria which were there have been killed and if your process of sterilization is complete, right? Now how will you find out that? That is why we have indicators for that. So when we place this indicator, now these indicators can be a color change which says that at the end of 1 hour you place this indicator and it shows a color change. Suppose the color change was expected, then yes, your process of sterilization has been effective. What is that medium you will use? You will use non-toxic strains of Clostridium tetani. And what you have is you have a tube. You have a special tube called Brownie's tube, which changes color and produces a green color at the end of 1 hour. All of you understood this? So there is a change in color, which is the organism we are using for indicator in hot air oven. It is important to note that you have to mention non-toxic strain. Because remember, Clostridium tetani can actually cause a tetanus infection. So you have to make sure you use a non-toxic strain of Clostridium tetani. That's again an important MCQ. Now let's go to moist heat. This was a dry heat technique. In moist heat, you have three things. We have below 100 degrees temperature. At 100 degrees temperature, and above 100 degrees temperature. Okay? So under moist heat we have three things. Before that we had dry heat. And dry heat ka example tha hot air oven. Now let's look into the details of these three things. First is moist heat, which is below 100 degrees Celsius. In that we have pasteurization. Two things under this. Eight has pasteurization. Second has vaccine bath. Vaccine bath especially meant for sterilization of vaccines where you maintain them at a temperature of 60 degrees Celsius. You need to know the values. All the values over here you need to be aware of. Under pasteurization technique, we have two types. All the trial users can also hear me, right? Trial user 5 and trial user 8. Kamal, Shweta, Anurag, Ritoban. Okay. Now let's go to... The thing is, Saurabh, I understand I can directly interact with you, but you should understand the only way I know if your AI is able to follow me is when to type. And in terms of interacting directly where I can give you voice power, imagine 14 of you having voices and all the background sound can also be heard. Kisi ke ghar pe kutta bhonk raha hoga na, so all of you can hear ki kisi ke ghar pe kutta bhonk raha. So it's very distracting. That's why. Okay. Yes. So the two techniques which come under moist heat, which is below 100 degrees, is in pasteurization. These temperatures are very important. Please learn these temperatures by heart, and it can be confusing. So please be very focused while you're reading it for the first time itself. Now, we have one thing called as 63 degrees Celsius pay on for 30 minutes. You will keep doing that. It's called as holder method. Ab holder method mein kya ho raha hai? You allow the medium to be heated for 30 minutes constantly at a standard temperature of 63 degrees Celsius. Why holder method? Because it's at 63 degrees for continuously 30 minutes. No change in temperature. Now, next is called as flash method. It happens in a matter of seconds. That's why it's flash. One thing that you have to change is you have a 15 to 20 minutes likha hai na. Please change that to seconds. Theek hai? So it's 15 to 20 seconds. So what you do is you initially heat the medium at a high temperature of 72 degrees. And after that, you cool it. Quickly cool it until it reaches a temperature of 13 degrees Celsius. So that's called as the flash method. So two methods under pasteurization. The method that is done at 100 degrees Celsius is the boiling. And now this boiling technique is not a very recommended technique. It does not kill all the microorganisms. So boiling should not be used as a technique, at least for your surgical instruments. One of the MCQ that was asked on this is if... surgical instruments can be sterilized by boiling. The answer is big no. It does not really kill all the microorganisms. So, you should not use boiling as a technique. Must be used in a lot of colleges. I don't disagree with that, but at least make sure that in a clinical practice, none of you are doing just boiling to autoclave, you know. I mean, sterilize instruments, please. Next is moist heat above 100 degrees Celsius. Again, you know, at this above 100 maybe, you have two techniques. One is at atmospheric pressure, where you maintain the same pressure as the atmosphere. And the one is above atmospheric pressure. Trial user, I didn't get you. Which is done in pasteurization, matlab? In pasteurization, you're doing below 100 degrees technique. Yeah, milk. The Then let's look first at moist heat, which is steam at atmospheric pressure. Now this technique is mainly used for the sterilization of culture media, a very important MCQ for you. Okay. Now there is a name of a technique called as tyndallization. This is a very important MCQ. It's also called as intermittent sterilization. अब इसमें हम करते क्या है कि this process is done for 3 days, continuous 3 days. Okay. First day you will heat for 20 minutes at a temperature of 100 degrees. Next day again you will heat at 100 degrees for 20 minutes. So like that you will do for 3 days. Okay. The purpose is that when you do on the first day, it is killing the existing living bacteria. The next day it is helping you kill the dormant bacteria. On the third day, all the existing bacteria will be killed. It's like that. So that is why you do it for 3 days. That's called as tyndallization. There's another important MCQ regarding this as sugar containing media are sterilized by tyndallization. Can you all write down that statement over here? Sugar containing media. It's actually culture media, no doubt. But there was a very specific MCQ which said that sugar containing media are sterilized by which technique? The answer is tyndallization. Please make a note of this in your key notes. Can all of you hear me now, or is there still an issue with my voice? Then next is we'll do moist heat under pressure, which is autoclave. Autoclave, all of us are quite clear. It is 121 degrees Celsius, 15 pound pressure. Recommended temperature is 15 minutes. This is going to be something like a baby learning ABCD again. All of you are quite clear with this, right? Temperature important, pressure important, duration important. Now there's another cycle. One cycle is कि आप 121 डिग्री पे 15 पाउंड पे 15 मिनट के लिए करो. Another cycle is everything has 3 in it. And that's another easy way to remember. Temperature is 134 degrees Celsius. Pressure is 30 pound. Temperature is 3 minutes. I mean duration. Everything is 3, 3, 3. 134, 33. That is another cycle. Easy? You got the values? 134-33 is another cycle. All right, that's about autoclave. And like how we use indicator in case of hotter oven, we also have an indicator here which is a chemical indicator. And the bacteria that is used in case of this is your Bacillus stereothermophilus. That's an indication for your autoclave being efficient or not. Okay. Next we go to filtration. Filtration is for use mainly for liquid. Any liquid, when you want to sterilize it, you will use the filtration method. And especially liquids which are sensitive to heat, where you can't subject them to heat, then you have to find a heat resistant method, right? So that's for filtration. You will do for vaccines and serum. Now the key word, if you have this MCQ, is filtration is going to be done for liquids which are heat labile, which means they get destroyed or changed when you subject them to heat. So it's useful only for heat labile liquid. That's the key word over here. Okay. Then you can also use radiation for sterilization. Now all of you know from the radiology class, there are two types of radiation. We have ionizing radiation and non-ionizing radiation. Ionizing radiation is also called as cold sterilization because these don't really create heat. While a non-ionizing is hot, they create some amount of heat. Example of that is infrared and UV. Are you guys following me, or you find the speed too fast? Fine. Okay. Good. Now, mass sterilization of needles. You will have two MCQs with respect to your syringes and needles. Have all of you seen your injection syringe? Have all of you tried and find out how it is sterilized? Gamma rays, yeah, there's always this confusion. Is it gamma rays? Is it UV rays? Or is it ethylene oxide sterilization? Heard of ethylene oxide sterilization? Yeah, you can use ethylene oxide for this as well. Ethylene oxide is also used for the sterilization of your syringes and needles. What is written on your pack is its means of sterilization before packaging, okay? Then ionizing is X-rays, gamma rays and cosmic rays. These are the examples of your ionizing radiation. Ionizing radiation, now, where will you use these? Like we've already seen, gamma rays can be used for syringes. It can also be used for these UV radiation and infrared, no? It can also be used for the sterilization of operation theaters. Okay? Instigators are different, Pratap. Now let's go to, yeah. Formaldehyde is another way of sterilizing your operation theaters. Next is chemical agents. All this while we've been seeing the mechanical methods of sterilizing. Now let's go to the chemical agents. And in that, the first thing you will come across with is alcohol. And about alcohol, let me tell you what is inspirator. Instigator is actually a method of evaporation. I can't recollect if we come across this in micro or dental materials, Pratap. And you're right with saying that incineration is burning. Yaar, waste management mein nahi aata inspirator. Incineration comes in waste management, which is burning. An inspissator or inspissation is a method of evaporation, but I'm not sure if it comes in sterilization part. Okay. Okay, there we have it. Very good. All right. Okay, let's get back. Alcohol, an important point over here is what percentage of alcohol is useful as a sterilizing agent? Anybody has an idea? How much of alcohol should you use? What percentage? Yeah, only 70% alcohol is useful as a sterilizing agent. Anything above it is not effective sterilizing agent. There's another MCQ which has come in past on whether 100% alcohol is effective as a sterilizing agent, and it is wrong. It is not useful. It is only a 70% alcohol which is useful. It could be any form of alcohol, ethyl alcohol or whatever. What does alcohol do? It basically brings about denaturation of proteins. It can be used as a surface disinfectant or a skin antiseptic. Next is formaldehyde. And formaldehyde, all of us know, it is one of the most common agents that is used for the sterilization of chambers. It could be your OT or it could be your surgical chambers, whatever. You will use the formaldehyde gas, so that is your fumigation technique. And how does this act is also against the proteins of the bactéria. So basically it is bactericidal. Glutaraldehyde, what they found in formaldehyde is that it could be toxic. So that is why they started substituting it with glutaraldehyde. And glutaraldehyde is actually used in the sterilization of your suture material. MCQ. You can use a lot of dyes and halogens. Halogens, I mean iodine. All of us are quite clear. Betadine is the most commonly used surface disinfectant, right? So that's an halogen, your iodine, povidone iodine, right? And phenols. Phenols is another important antiseptic agent. It is the most common antiseptic agent which is used, in fact. And who introduced phenol is a very important MCQ. It was introduced by Lister. And Lister has been termed as the father of antiseptic surgery. Both of them are important MCQs. Another thing you all can do is dyes. Sometimes your methylene blow, etc., no? They can also serve you as an emergency disinfectant. Okay? Well, what I was telling you is fathers. You have to dedicate one page in your notes, the point book that you are maintaining, for all the fathers. Father of surgery, generally, I mean general surgery, there's a different one, okay? There's a father of general surgery and there is a father of oral surgery. There's father of epidemiology, there is father of cariology, and I don't know, kitne sare father. Here you have a father of antiseptic surgery, which is Lister. So dedicate one page, or jahan pe bhi when you're reading the subject wise and you get that point on father of, mention that over there so you can revise it later on. Now we go to the individual items which may be slightly dental related and how they can be sterilized. Dappen dishes and glass slab, you'll only swap them with thermocrasol and double swap them with alcohol. Gatapacha cone, very important MCQ. You will actually do it with 5.25% sodium hypochlorite for a duration of 1 minute. You should not forget the duration, you should not forget the percentage and the material used. So what is it? It's 5.25% sodium hypochlorite for 1 minute. Okay, then rinse it in hydrogen peroxide and then dry it. This process has been asked many times as MCQ. Alright, then comes silver cone. Now silver cone being a metal one, you can always heat it, but pass it through a very low flame for 3 to 4 times. And another way is you can immerse it in a hot salt sterilizer for 5 seconds. All your vaccine, serum, antibiotic solutions, of course they are heat labile, they will be by filtration method. Then, like how we had an indicator for hot air oven as well as autoclave, you will also have an indicator for your chemicals. So in order to test how efficacious your chemicals are as a sterilizing agent, there is something called, what they used is phenol. They used phenol as a standard material. Anyways, it was the first material to be used, okay? So keeping your phenol as a standard, they came up with a test. The name of the test is the Riedel-Walker test, okay? And it's also called as a phenol coefficient test. Now, whenever you test the efficacy of any chemical agent, you will be comparing it with phenol because you're using phenol as a standard material. Okay, and the bacteria that is used in that case is again the non-toxic strains of Salmonella type 5. Basic principle is that whichever material, sterilizing material you're using should be at least able to kill your Salmonella type 5. That is how you test the efficacy of that chemical agent. And there is a value for this, okay? The value is the phenol coefficient test has been equal to 1, which means the efficacy of phenol was equal to 1. So that's the numerical value, and when you test the efficacy of any other chemical agent, it should be closer to 1 or it should be greater than 1. Then that material is considered as a good sterilizing agent. So please make a note of this value. If not, then your key notes, just write it down. Another test is called as the Chick-Martin test. Now that is used for again another test for a disinfectant, a chemical agent. Here you will use water containing 3% human fecus. It's very thin. Again, your human fecus will have Salmonella in it. This is one type of a test for chemical agent. This is the second test. First test is phenol coefficient or Riedel Walker test. And you will use Salmonella type 5. That chemical agent should be able to kill your Salmonella. Next test is the Chick-Martin test. Here again, whichever disinfectant you want to test, you will pour it in water which has 3% human fecus. Concept remains the same. The bacteria that is majority that is present in the fecus is your Salmonella. So it should be effective against your Salmonella. Clear with this so far? Any doubts on sterilization and disinfection as yet? Let's start with bacteriology.